Welcome to class 9 students. This is the continuation part of the chapter transpiration. In my previous video I had started this chapter and I have discussed with you what is transpiration, why transpiration needs to happen, the difference between transpiration and evaporation, the main sites of transpiration which are stomata, cuticle and lenticels, and the major transpiration means the major part of transpiration takes place through the stomata. And then I just told you which external factors control transpiration. Today I am going to start from that point only, and I am going to explain how each factor affects the rate of transpiration. So the first point was temperature, right? So let's talk how temperature affects the rate of transpiration. Reading from your book, the effect of temperature upon the rate of transpiration can be analyzed in terms of its effects on vapor pressure within the leaf and outside atmosphere. You don't need to read all these things. Start from the second line, okay? A rise in temperature causes a decrease in the relative humidity of the air and results in an increase in the rate of transpiration. So what is it saying? If temperature is going up, okay, a rise in temperature, increase in rate of transpiration, transpiration will also go up. If temperature is going up, so let's draw this arrow right beside temperature, then you will be able to understand. If temperature is going up, that means rise in temperature increases the rate of transpiration. I have given both upwards arrows, that means both are increasing. So a rise in temperature, why is it happening? Because a rise in temperature causes a decrease in relative humidity. Humidity is decreasing. Relative humidity, not just humidity. Relative humidity is decreasing when temperature is rising, and as a result, transpiration is increasing. Okay, because humidity means when there will be less humidity or less water vapor in the air surrounding the trees, then the air surrounding the trees or the atmosphere which is surrounding the trees, that will be better capable to absorb water vapor which is given out in the form of transpiration. So if the relative humidity is low, then transpiration, the rate of transpiration will be high. So temperature, when it is increasing, relative humidity is decreasing and rate of transpiration is increasing. Okay, generally 10 to 25 degrees Celsius temperature is the ideal range for stomatal opening where rapid rate of diffusion takes place. So let's write it down. So this you have understood, right? Temperature, if it is increasing, the rate of transpiration will also increase. And what is the ideal range of temperature? 10 to 25 degrees Celsius. 10 to 25 degrees Celsius is the ideal range of temperature where there is rapid rate of transpiration. Moving on to the second point, which is humidity. What is it saying? Transpiration depends upon the, again you don't have to read the first line, start from the second line. Transpiration rate increases at lower humidity. So previously, in the previous point only, we have seen that transpiration rate increases at lower humidity, okay, and decreases at higher humidity. So humidity low, transpiration low. Humidity high, transpiration high. Is it clear? When there is low humidity in the atmosphere that is surrounding the trees, that means there is less amount of water vapor in the air, so that air can take up more water vapor which is given out in the process of transpiration. So the plants will do a faster rate of transpiration. Okay, so transpiration is always directly proportional to humidity. Clear? Third one. So let's rub this one. I hope you have understood. Third one is wind. Let's see. Wind velocity directly influences the rate of transpiration. So here also, rate of transpiration is directly related to wind. The rate of transpiration usually increases with the increase in the velocity of the wind. If there is high wind, high speed wind blowing through a region, all the trees in that area will perform transpiration in a very rapid rate. Okay, The rate of transpiration increases with the increase in the velocity of wind, whereas quiet atmosphere, no breeze, no such breeze, no wind at all, it retards the rate of transpiration. Clear? So this one is also directly proportional along with the rate of transpiration. Coming to the fourth point, which is light. Okay, light generally, stomata remains open during daytime and closed during night due to photosynthetic gaseous exchange. We all know that stomata opens during the daytime and it remains closed during the night time. Thus, the rate of stomatal transpiration is higher. So obviously, we know that the transpiration, major part of the transpiration of a particular plant, 80 to 90% of it takes place through the stomata. So if it is open in the day and closed at night, then in the day when there is light, there will be higher rate of transpiration, and at night only the cuticles and the lenticels will perform little bit of transpiration, at least 10 to 12% of transpiration. So obviously, with light, rate of stomatal transpiration increases. Okay, so these are the four points you need to learn and how they affect the rate of transpiration. This also you need to learn from this. Okay, I hope you have understood this. Next, moving on to the significance of transpiration. Significance. First, we will talk about the beneficial role. Means in significance, we have both the beneficial role and the harmful role. Okay, we are going to do the beneficial role of transpiration first. Means how transpiration benefits the plant. First one is ascent of sap. So basically, what is ascent of sap? You have to know that first. You are familiar with this word sap. Sap is the watery fluid that is found within the vacuoles of the plant cells, and those watery fluid then go upward. So that is the ascent, means going upward in the plants of the sap. So ascent of sap mostly occurs due to transpiration pull exerted on water channels of the plant. So water channels are there, xylem vessel is there, so they exert a pull on the ascent of sap, and this is mainly due to transpiration. Okay, so for transpiration to happen, they need a lot of water. And where is that water? Where will that water come from? It is the watery fluid, the sap of the plant cells, and over it the transpiration pull is there, which will bring it above from the means from near the soil surface to the leaves, from where the transpiration will take place. Okay, next one is passive water absorption. What is passive water absorption? Passive water absorption from soil by roots is mainly due to the presence of continuous transpiration during daytime. So previously I have explained that during day, due to the means as the stomata remains open during the daytime, the transpiration rate is very high during the day, and then that is why there is passive water absorption from the soil by the roots due to the presence of continuous transpiration. Means during the day continuous transpiration happens, and that is why there is passive water absorption from the soil by the root hairs. Okay, so I have discussed two points today of the beneficial role of transpiration. There are a few more points, and then we will do the harmful roles. So I will continue with the beneficial role in the next video. Okay.